Yul, you played 14 years ago.
Yep.
The iPhone didn't even exist. So do you see this game today through a different prism as a more mature human?
Yeah, I feel like a dinosaur that's been time-bombed into the future. The world has changed, the people have changed, Survivor has changed, and I think I'm gonna have to change.
We get to our island, and I'm thinking, I can't believe this is happening. I was just super happy to be on Survivor again, and especially kind of a all-winners edition. But seeing all these people and realizing how long ago I played, it's kind of overwhelming.
I would love to work with you.
Really?
Yeah.
You can, like, punctuate that with more.
When I played Cook Islands, I tried to play a very rational, strategic game. I used a lot of game theory, used a lot of math. But this season, I think my biggest challenge will be coming in disconnected. I haven't been part of the Survivor community. A lot of these people have played with each other. They know each other. Among the people played multiple times, you have Boston Rob, you have Tyson, who play together. They're like best friends, right? And they not only play Survivor together, they play poker together. Then they also play with Kim Spradlin and Jeremy Collins. And I remember watching one video where Tyson actually said something to the effect of, hey, if we're ever on an island, this is gonna be the power alliance.
If we all find ourselves on the island together, we're definitely gonna be the power alliance.
Definitely, obviously.
Duh.
Come on!
It's almost like me, Nick, and Wendell are more of like the free agents.
So you, how are you feeling, you free agent?
Yeah, I don't know anybody, so I would be happy to work with anyone who wants to work with me.
People are trying to recruit soldiers into their alliances. Sarah and Sandra, they're trying to align all the unconnected people. But as it turns out, that alliance, which is basically people who are one-time players and fairly disconnected from other winners, is actually the alliance that I've been organizing. And that is me, Nick, Wendell, and Sophie.
I believe that Amber and Rob should definitely get to the edge of extinction as soon as possible.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
The great thing is, I don't think people even know that this alliance even exists. And with Sandra, as well as with Sarah, we'll have numbers. In fact, we'll control the game.
Second person voted out of Survivor, Winners at War, Amber.
I've been trying to get some breadfruit for the last few days, and unfortunately have not been going very well. But I'm determined not to give up, even though I'm probably losing a lot more calories than I hope to gain from this. I got this big bamboo stick, and I tied a rope around it. So hopefully it'll act as kind of like a wire coat hanger. I can try to loop it and pull it down.
All right, I think I got it. Got it.
So smallish.
Well, at least I know the technique works.
So I know Tyson is targeting Sandra, but I don't want to lose Sandra.
Tyson's saying, hey, we should vote out Sandra. I think she'd run in the show. I think this will be something that everyone can get behind. Tony and Sarah will, I think, get on board with it. We don't.
I guess we don't have to worry until if we lose the challenge.
Okay.
If you come after me, I better not find out about it.
Right now, we all like each other and can still continue with this illusion that we're all tight with one another. But in reality, me and Nick, Wendell, and Sophie, we're the strongest alliance within this tribe, and I don't think anyone's suspecting that that's the case. So right now, I feel good. Like, I have maximum range of options in front of me.
Tyson wants to go for you.
I'm gonna walk down there now, okay?
All right.
Why does he want to go for me?
He wants an easy vote.
He thinks you won't see it coming, that's why.
He won't see it coming. He's going for you. The plan is, we're all gonna get Tyson.
The one thing that's really struck me is, like, the reality of who they actually are is very different from what I thought coming into the game. I mean, like, Tony, I thought was gonna be an ass. Tony's actually a really caring person. Like, people like him.
Fifth person voted out of Survivor, Winners at War, Tyson.
I know Jonathan Penner because Jonathan is someone I played with on Cook Islands. We've become very close friends, and I've become closer with his family.
Jonathan, say hello to your wife, Stacy.
And over the past year, his wife, Stacy Tidal, who's an amazing woman, was diagnosed with ALS, Lou Gehrig's disease. And it's been an absolutely devastating knockout punch. This season of Survivor, I feel like I'm not just playing for myself or my own family, but I'm playing for something bigger than myself. I would just love to use this opportunity to try to raise awareness of anyone who's suffering from ALS and their families who really are in need, you know, much more than any of us are.
Everybody, drop your buffs. We are switching tribes.
All right, let's take a look at our new tribes. Wearing blue, the new Cellate tribe is Parvati, Nick, Yul, Michelle, and Wendell. We have two former Cellate and three Dakal.
What is your wife's name?
Sophie. It was funny. She's actually a big fan of yours.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, I like her already.
Yeah.
You guys are gonna write Parv down.
Yeah.
We're gonna hope she doesn't have anything special.
seventh person voted out a survivor, Winners at War.
Parvati.
Tribal Council kind of sucked. Wendell got into it with Parvati, which was completely unnecessary. And then at one point, he basically said, make me an offer. Tell me who to vote out. And I'm open to working with you. And I'm sitting there thinking, like, what the hell are you doing? He created a lot more drama, a lot more uncertainty, and almost kind of blew things up for no reason. After our conversation, I just got to watch him. I'll see how he, what he does in future tribal councils.
I wasn't necessarily uncomfortable, but I think it could create chaos amongst allies.
Wow.
And also, I've seen every single person who's created that chaos walk out the door. I think in the future...
I understand. Thank you for schooling me.
I'm not trying to...
About how to interact at tribal.
How did your conversation go with him?
Not well. How did yours
I heard
go?
It. Mine went fine, but he definitely has a different tone and demeanor with you than he does with me.
Like, he was very... He was like, thank you, I appreciate you telling me this stuff. Very respectful. What I could overhear seemed defensive. Kind of telling you how it is and being sort of passive aggressive. I heard the schooling thing and I was like, what?
The four of us are tight, but Wendell is a little bit of a showboat. He's a little bit of a trash talker. And if he had just maintained his focus, that could have made the difference between winning and losing today. So he's basically dug his own grave.
All right, so real quick, just while they're talking, so the plan is Wendell?
Yeah.
But we're going to tell Wendell that we're voting Michelle.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
I have an idea for how we might be able to get Wendell's fire token.
We tell Wendell she'd be voting for me and Michelle would be voting for me. But the reality though is that you and Michelle would put out Wendell. That way, at least there's some chance Michelle might get Wendell's fire tokens. In which case, I would have some risk because my name gets written down. I would like some compensation. I'd like to get a fire token.
The fire tokens gives you an opportunity to have this kind of market economy to align incentives. So for example, you might say, okay, I think we should do this, but the person says, no, this is too risky. I don't want to do it. But what if I give you a fire token to do it? Then at that point, the economics work out. They're thinking, okay, the reward is worth the risk, and that adds a whole new layer of options that didn't exist before. I will be very bitter at you guys if you blindside me tonight, but I want to leave the option of working with you because that may be my only option. And so far, I feel like I know you better than I know anyone else in the game.
Ninth person voted out, Yul.
Getting so close to the merge and just literally being a split second away from winning immunity and making it and being blindsided is a bitter pill to swallow.
New schoolers got the old schoolers.
I was the last one. I assume that we'll have an opportunity to battle back soon and just try to remind myself this is an adventure and I feel lucky to be here.
Oh my God, it's our families!
I can't describe how much sheer joy and happiness I felt in that moment.
Bye, bye, Daddy.
When I got to Extinction Island, I was really struggling with whether I should pull the white flag. So I was thinking, like, as a father, what is the right thing for me to do? Like, should I pull the white flag, go home, and spend this quality time with my kids that I won't have again for a really long time? On the other hand, I don't want my kids to think I'm a quitter. You know, a day or two later, I hear Natalie shouting,
"What the hell?
Our families are here! Our families are here!" And I see my wife and my two girls, and just seeing them coming out here was so amazing for me. It's just, oh my God. And it just, at that moment, I was so thankful that I didn't pull that flag, because if I pulled that flag, I wouldn't have seen them. I think after I saw my family, it just really crystallized for me. No matter how this game plays out, no matter whether I get back in the game or not, I'm so glad I came here because it made me realize how much I love them, how much I've been taking my life for granted. When I look in the grand scheme of things, I'm so lucky, I'm so blessed. Like, I feel like I've won Survivor, the Survivor game of life, you know? I didn't come here thinking I was gonna find myself. I didn't come here thinking I was gonna have any major revelations. But man, I was wrong. I think it took me this time to step back and just completely get outside of my normal life to see how truly fortunate I am. And I think just having that realization epiphany has made this entire experience totally worthwhile.
You must retrieve 20 coconuts and stack them next to your shelter, one coconut at a time. The first 6 to accomplish this task will earn 2 fire tokens.
Yes, you all.
Yeah, you.
Good work.
To my big surprise, I ended up in 3rd place. Now that I've had a chance to see the fire tokens actually used and in play,
I think that's a really interesting dynamic. It adds a layer of nuance and complexity and flexibility that didn't exist before. So I'm inclined to use my tokens for an advantage in the challenge.
She's got it! Into this game.
When I was a kid, I was an incredibly introverted person. But winning Survivor kind of validated the kind of person I'd grown into, which is priceless.